Start this webinar of why we should protect with Type B solutions of residual current devices. And before to start, let me make some context, and I want to introduce some main and basic features of an RCD. Probably you already have listened all of these definitions, okay? Because this is very basic concepts. But I think that it's good that we started with this level, okay? Just in order to have some context, as I said. Okay, so let's start for rated current, so everybody knows that that name, okay? So this is the total current from the load that we need to protect, okay? So the most typical examples for the residual current circuit breakers, okay, which have the rated current by itself, it's 63, 40 amps, okay? This is a very typical rated currents for these RCDs, okay? Let's follow with the next example, next concept, which is the breaking rated capacity, which is the maximum current that the RCD can open, okay? Usually for a residual current circuit breaker, an RCCV, the most typical examples are 630 amps, maybe 1,000 amps. So this level of values, let's say, okay. As you probably have seen, this is lower values considering short circuits, okay. So RCDs, as you probably know, do not protect against short circuits, okay. So the main feature, the main functionality of the RCDs are protect against leakage in and residual currents. Okay, so in case of short circuit of the installation, the residual current device will not protect properly. Okay, so let's follow with the next example and let's see the sensitivity. Okay, this is the typical concept for the residual current devices, okay, which is the tripping value for the residual current device, okay. So probably you already know the most typical examples, okay, which are the 30 milliamps. These 30 milliamps are very important because these values, it's the maximum current allowed to pass through the human body, okay, without any kind of damage, okay, for the body. So this value is for protecting people, okay. So very important in that sense, that value. And probably you know other sensitivities as 300 milliamps, 500 milliamps. 300 milliamps, it's very common to protect any kind of loads, okay. And higher values than 300 milliamps are usually used to protect sub cabinets or main cabinets in the mains of the installation. Okay, let's follow with some other concepts with delay or defining tripping curve. Okay, this is a definition where the RCDs are classified depending on the delay or which are they adjusted, okay, or the tripping time curve, okay. The most typical ones, and probably you already have heard about it, are the instantaneous, which is the most faster tripping curve, which can be used in the residual current device, okay. The selective curve, which is the typical one which is used for sub cabinets or main cabinets, okay. With the most important feature of this time curve tripping definite curve is that it's have some delay if we compare to the instantaneous one, okay. And other delays that can be adjusted are time-definite delays, okay? So probably you have seen 500 milliseconds or 1 second, 3, 5, 10 seconds. This is typical examples of delays which can be adjustable in adjusted in a RCD. Okay. Another concept for the RCDs is the type. Okay, I will not go very deep right now in this concept because we will follow and well, we will see deeper in the next chart, and we will have a lot of information regarding this main topic, which are the type of RCDs. Let me explain that there are four types according to the main standards, which are AC, A, F, and B. As I said, we will go deeper, further on. Okay, so keep in mind these different letters, and we will go deeper. Okay, so finally, in order to make this context to the webinar, I will explain some definitions that you have probably seen in the catalogs or bulletins of the different manufacturers, okay, and the different brands that sells the different solutions of RCDs, okay. And I think that it's very useful that we keep in mind what does these letters means, okay. And let's see what does it mean. Starts with RCD, okay. This is acronymous for the residual current device. Okay, this is a general common definition for all kind, any type of residual current protection or residual current monitoring devices. Okay, so this is a common name that covers everything. Let's follow with RCM. This is residual current monitoring. Okay, this is a type of resident current device which are used in order to monitor the leakage on the facility, the installation. Okay, and you have an example just in the slide, okay, because I include a picture, okay, of RGU10V, which is a relay, an RCD type B, which I will explain, I will give you further information of this relay in the following minutes. Okay. So this relay, the RGU10B, can be used as an RCM, okay, because with its display you can follow the leakage in real time. Okay, so this is an example of this solution. Let's follow with RCCB, which is a residual current circuit breaker, and this is a very common solution for lower currents. Okay, and includes all the solution, all in one solution. Okay, that means the circuit breaker, the transformer, and the main operation, the main system, in order to measure the leakage and to trip in case that we need. Okay. And the last one is the MRCD, which is the name that means modular residual current device. This is the typical solution with relay, transformer, and circuit breaker. Okay, this is the typical solution of circuitor, the traditional one, I mean, and this is more common in order to protect, to measure currents higher than 100 or 150 amps, which is the most common rated current values for RCCBs. Okay, so let's continue with the webinar. Okay, we have seen the previous concepts, and we are going to see deeper, as I said in the previous slide, the different types of RCDs according to the standards. And let's start with this, the types of RCBs. This is according to the standards that you can read in the slide. Okay, and let's start with a very simple definition of each one, and we will see more features and more characteristics of this of each kind, okay, in the following slides. So let's start with type AC, and at the beginning, let me Let me put the focus on the symbology, okay? Because you can see a symbol at the site of each type, okay? And this symbol is not a symbology that have been invented for Circutor, okay? Because this is a symbology that it's taken from the standards that you can see in the slide, okay? And these symbology are used in order to identify the different RCDs, okay? Because you will not never find the name written in the product, okay? So if you take an RCD in your hands and read what you see in the device, you will not never find type AC or type A or type F or type B. If you are looking for the type of the RCD that you have in your hands, you need to look for the symbology that you can see next to the type in this slide. Okay, and let me explain that the symbology is very very intuitive, because we can see what kind of protection can give this type of RCD. So let's start with the most basic one, and I will start with the most basic one and go with the highest ones, okay? So the most basic one, it's the type AC, which only can protect against sinusoidal alternating current. So we will look deeper, okay, into that in the next slides. So next type, it's type A, which can protect sinusoidal alternating currents and pulsating currents. So again, look at the symbology next to the text, okay? Go on with the type F, which can protect the sinusoidal alternating currents and pulsating currents and mixed AC and DC, okay? So as you can see, we are going adding the previous ones into the next one, okay? So this is very interesting in that sense. And again, the symbology are according to that. And finally, the type B, it's sinusoidal alternating currents, pulsating currents, and it's the key point of that type of RCD, the DC current. Okay, so this is very very important, and I want to put the focus on that feature. Okay, so move on with the webinar, and let's see deeper each type of RCD, okay, and let's see what the main features of each one, starting with the type IC, okay, which, as I said, it's the most basic protection against electrical leakage, okay. So this is a protection only against sinusoidal residual current, okay? So that's it. So as you can see, this is a very, very basic protection, okay? And the main typical applications, almost in Spain, okay? But in other countries, it's like in Spain, are for residential or offices use, okay? So that's it. Not recommended at all for industries, because industries has a behavior different than a sinusoidal wave, let's say. Okay. So of course, that solution will not be a proper one in that cases for industrial services or so on. Okay. So let me say that the solution that this type AC RCD type, okay, are not allowed in many countries. For example, in Germany or in Belgium, but in other Central European countries, okay, and northern countries as well. So, as I said, it's a very, very basic type of earth leakage protection, and it's not very common because it's too basic. Let's say it that way. Okay. Let's continue with the tape A. Okay. And this starts from AC type, okay? So have the same protection against sinusoidal alternating residual currents, and adds the following features: protection against direct pulsant currents, and protection against direct pulsant currents with smooth residual direct current up to 6 milliamps. And this is exactly the text that we can read in the standards. Okay, so this is a very important concept. This smooth residual direct protection up to 6 milliamps. Okay, because it's a concept that we will see in the next slides. That it's a concept that it's introduced in particular application, which is the electrical vehicle recharge, okay, and we will see further on. So please keep in mind that feature, and we will follow that values, okay. So these type A solutions, it's very common in the industrial applications. And probably you already have listened about the immune solutions, okay? Because these kind of solutions, these immune solutions, are very, very extended in the market, okay? And well, this is an extra value that all the manufacturers give to the products, okay? Which is not included in the standards, okay? So if the standard says, okay, you need to get up to here, okay, up to these values. Then the manufacturer says to the market, okay, I want to give some added value, and let's say I will add some extra values that are not included in the standard. Okay, it's not mandatory to include these values and these features in the type A solutions, according to the standards, but manufacturers wants to sell a lot and wants their customers happy, and include the let's say some kind of extra features, okay, in order to improve the solution, okay. That's that extra features are usually protection against transients, okay, because it's very typical that maybe you have a storm in your nearby, and maybe you have lightning, and this trips the installation, okay. So if you have immunity against this transient, you will avoid this unwanted trip, okay. And these immune solutions always include some kind of immunity against harmonics, okay. So this is very interesting in the industrial sector. And finally, they usually hold the trip farther than the solutions type A, okay. So this is the different let's say features that Circutor includes in the ultra immune system, that which are included in all the type A solutions that are in the Circutor's catalog. Okay, so well, that's it about the type A, which is the most common solution up to now in the market. Okay, probably you already have listened about that. Okay, and we will continue with type F, okay? Again, we need to start with from the I-tape solutions, okay? So from type 8, we add protection against residual alternating current. And here the standard includes some type of protection for some composite waveforms up to 1000 hertz, okay, 1 kilohertz. And again, the standard adds some protection against residual alternating current with protection superimposed on a smooth direct current. Okay, that means that's a definition of some kind of mixed of AC and DC. Okay, this type F solution is very, very, very special. To be honest, it's not very common. Okay, in the market, because A-type solutions with immune systems are quite close to the type F solutions, okay? And these solutions are very, these immune solutions are very extended in the market. So this type F solution, this kind of RCDs, the type F, are not extended in the market and are only used in some countries like Germany again, and are used in an industrial applications with single phase variable speed drives, and that's it. Okay, it's not very it's not a very common solution. Okay, so we don't put the focus on that one. Okay, and let's follow with the last one, but not the less important one. Okay, because in my opinion, it's the most important one, and this is the present and future of the RCDs and the earth leakage protection as well. And this is the type B of RCDs, and this is starts from which the features that has the type F. So again, we have the AC features, the A features, the F features, and type B at the protection for residual sinusoidal alternating currents up to 1 kilohertz, okay? And here, if we compare with F-type, it's not only a concrete or a unique waveform, but every waveform up to 1 kilohertz, okay? And adds protection against residual direct current that can appear with rectified circuits. The standard has a very clear approach to this kind of loads, okay, which are the variable speed drive, which uses the 3 or 6 pulses bridge. Okay, so this is very important. And finally, but not less important, protection against residual direct current. Okay, and this is the key point, the key feature of that type B solution. Because as you probably know, there are a lot of applications that in present uses DC current, okay, in the way that he works, in the way that this load works. For example, variable speed drive, UPS, and electrical vehicle recharge, and so on, so on. Okay, so this is a very important type of RCDs which have increased the volume in the market. Okay, so we have seen the different types of RCDs according to the standards, but we need to know what happens if we choose wrong, if we choose the not proper type in my facility, in my installation, and let's see what happens, okay? Because the election of the RCD is a key factor in order to protect our loads and in order to protect our facilities. We can if we have a bad choice in our RCD, we can see two different scenarios. The best one, okay, and I want to explain you that it's not a good one, but it's the best, okay. The RCD becomes very, very sensitive, okay, and the situation is that one. Let me explain the context first of all, because we let's imagine that we protect a variable speed drive, okay, or one of these DC load, let's say, okay, these loads that can work with DC, okay, with an AC or an A type, which are RCD types that as we have seen just a few minutes ago, are not proper for that kind of solutions or that kind of loads as variable speed drive, UPS, and so on. Okay, so in this situation, the two different scenarios that we can see, the best one, as I told you, the RCD becomes very, very sensitive depending on the transformer that uses, and this can cause some unwanted trips. Okay, and this is very, very usually very painful for the installation, very, very disturbing in order because the production of the factory of the facility stops. Okay, and this usually means a lot of money and so on. Okay, so this is a very uncomfortable situation. This is it. And this was the best scenario. Okay, but the worst is that the RCD becomes blind. That means that they cannot see any kind of leakage, and we have a very dangerous situation right there. Okay, and it doesn't trip. The RCD becomes blocked, and doesn't trip when it should. Okay, so in some cases that can mean mortal danger, as you can imagine. Okay, so very important the election of RCDs in that sense. So if the importance of the type of the RCD that we choose on our facilities, on our installations, are such important as that, we can imagine the legal context and the regulations and choosing a good RCD are very important. So let's see which is the legal context. Okay, I obviously put the focus on Spain, but I really know because we are very close to our customers, not only in Spain but in Europe and all over the world, because Circutor has strong presence in all the countries and all the continents, in several countries, sorry, and in all the continents. So we know because customers told us that in some European countries where the air leakage protection are more extended, the regulations are quite similar to Spain, with their own particularities, okay, that's clear. But it could work as an example in order to see which is the way, or which is the best way in order to choose our type of RCDs according to the regulations and the standards. And before to see the regulations and the standards, I want to put again some context, because the regulations were born in order to protect people, okay? Because this is a real situation. According to the World Health Organization, this last year, more than 100 of people died per country. Okay, and with a lot, this was deaths of direct deaths. Okay, so air leakage protection can avoid some victims per country, and this is clear. Again, another topic that is very important with the residual current protection, is that kind of protection can avoid and can protect against isolation problems in our facilities, in our loads. Okay, and that bad isolation problems can cause more than 7,000 fires in a country like Spain. Probably countries next to Spain, European countries, and other first world countries, let's say, have the same problems as well. Residual current protection, it's very important in order to avoid that kind of problems. And finally, a shutdown in case of residual current problems or bad election of your type of RCD can cost 330,000 euros per minute in telecom services. Again, the protection or the choosing a right protection for your facilities will avoid a lot of problems. So let's see how to choose according to the standards. And again, it's quite similar in all other European countries. What's the legal context and the regulations here in Spain? In Spain, we have the Spanish Low Voltage Electrotechnical Regulation, which is the Reglamento Electrotécnico de Baja Tensión in Spanish, which is mandatory in all the country. And in that regulation, it said that it's mandatory to protect against residual current. But it's not definite which type of RCD you should use. There's only one exception, which is the electrical vehicle recharge. And as far as we know, there are similar regulations in European countries, as I said. I understand that you will not understand Spanish, but let me put the focus on that EV charge application, which is included in the Spanish regulation, because we know that there are very similar regulations again in all over Europe. And in that case, this is a very common standard, in all European countries. So in this case, EV charge, the Spanish regulations, they say that this EV charge must be protected with type B or type A, which, if you remember, when I explained it, the DC residual current detection for higher values than 6 milliamps, because type I, remember what I explained it, because I said, please remember that point. A types are not protecting for DC currents higher than 6 milliamps. This is very important because EV charge points can use and can have leakages for higher values than 6 milliamps. So A type in that cases will not be the proper device in order to protect that kind of loads. The different regulation, the Spanish regulation in that case, but so many others, includes a special product which should include this special disconnection in case that the leakage will be higher than 6 milliamps. And this is important because people are looking for that kind of solutions for EV charge. We will see further on what kind of solutions we can offer to the market. So if we, as we can see, the Spanish regulations do not say anything about regarding the how can we choose the type of or RCDs. So how do I choose the proper type of RCD? And further on, when the standards include that different type of waveforms, and these standards are very clear. Not all residual current are at 50 hertz, and we just need to See the six pulse bridge, which is in the fourth column, okay, the third line. And this is the typical drawing and a schematic of a six pulse bridge. And the next column, you will see the normal main current for that kind of load, okay, which is not very sinusoidal, but we can see that has this waveform, which is in both sides, okay, of the line. But in case of the earth leakage fault of this load, and this is the last column, okay, we can see very, very clear which this fault, this earth fault earth current, it's only in the positive side, okay, because below the line we can see nothing, okay. So this means a very clear way to see a DC current, okay. That means if six pulse bridge have a leakage, the waveform that we can see in that leakage is DC current. So in that cases we need to protect the SIM standard. It's telling us that we need to protect each load depending on the how is the fault earth current, okay. And taking care of that, who knows better than different manufacturers of the load how does the load works, okay. Well, this is the correct answer. Manufacturers knows very, very well how the load is working, okay, and they always advise to us which type of protection we need to use. So the best way in order to choose or type of protection, it's not following regulations, okay. Probably I do not explain well because I'm not telling you not to follow the regulations, okay. Please follow always the main regulations of your country. But usually what I mean is that usually different countries do not regulate that kind of solution. I mean, they do not regulate which type of RCD we need to use, okay. So in that cases that we do not have any kind of regulation, then we need to follow what the manual from manufacturers told us, okay. And I have included in this webinar some examples, okay, in order to see that in that cases the different manufacturers are very, very clear in some cases, and we need to protect with type B solutions, okay. Let's start with this one, which is a variable speed drive coming from ABB, okay, which is a very well-known brand, okay. And in the manual, in the part that they are talking about residual current device compatibility, they said, and I read textually, drives with residual current, sorry, ACS 150-03EX drives with residual current devices of type B, okay. So it's clear in that sense they should be protected with type B. Let's see other examples. In that case, another VSD, another variable speed drive, this is coming from Siemens, MicroMaster 420. And in that case, the definition of type B appears twice in the manual, okay. First of all, when they talk about the operation with residual current devices, so and this is a very important sentence, and I will put the focus on that, so keep attention please. If an RCD is fitted, the MicroMaster inverters will operate without nuisance tripping, provided that a type B RCD is used. So the manual itself, the main manufacturer of the load, are telling us if we do not use the proper RCD to protect, we will have some problems. So very, very important to choose the proper type of RCD in order to choose. And it's that's not it, because if we continue with the same manual, with the warnings, again, the triangle, so this is important, and we need to use an RCD type B. This is what the manual says. Let's follow with more examples. Sorry. this is manuals from Sally Crew, which is a manufacturer of UPS. And again, two different models, the SLC Elite Max and the SLC Twin Pro. And in both manuals, you can read the text, because in both of them, they are talking of the UPS should be protected with type B RCDs. So let's keep continue. Active filters, again, this is active filters coming from Circutor. We are the manufacturers of the solution, so we know it very well. So we know that it must be protected with type B, RCD type B. So it's included in the manual. EV charge as well. So depending on the power, we know very well that type A solutions should to be used, or type B some cases, so very important. And in some other applications, I have looked for some manuals that include the type B solutions of some inverters that are used in photovoltaic applications. To be honest, I didn't found it, but I think that it's common sense in order to think that the most proper type of RCD that needs to be installed in that kind of application should be type B as well. Okay, so we have seen that the solution or the type B solutions are included in most of the manuals of some kind of loads. Okay, so in case that we need to protect the load, it's clear we need to see the manual. Okay, but what happens when we need to do upstream coordination? Okay, and I put this slide of upstream coordination. I will not put the focus on all the coordination that you need to take in care on when you do that coordination. Okay, let's just say that you need to take into account the ammeter coordination, the chronometric coordination, and this is in order to The main target of these coordinations are that they are looking that the first RCD that should trip, it's the most closest one to the load. Okay, so this is what this coordination are looking for. Okay, but you need to take into account more important coordination, or another type of coordination, which is the type coordination, okay, of the type RCD coordination. And you need to consider that RCD coordination, the RCD must be of the same time or better upstream, okay, than downstream. So what does it mean? Maybe you will see clear in the following examples. So if you put A type protecting the load, when you are installing upstream another RCD, it not be most basic, more basic than the previous one. So AC it's not correct for that situation. We are connected tape I in the load, so AC it's not corrected upstream. So A it's corrected because it's the same level. B it's corrected because it's higher features. Okay, so you have this example. So please take into account when you design your lines, okay, and your coordination of your protections. Finally, and we almost finished. I don't want to leave you without explaining the solutions, Circutor solutions that we have with type B. First of all, the IDV4, this is an RCCP. Remember, I explained it at the beginning. You can see the symbology just next to the name, okay? Take into account every time you are looking for an RCD in order to see what kind of what type of RCD is the device, okay? So the IDV4 is an RCCV, which the most basic features are 40 or 63 amps. We have the solution for single phase and three phase applications, always the with four poles, 30 or 300 milliamps. We have in the range the 30 milliamps instantaneous trip available. This is very interesting because it's very looking in the market. Okay, so the product is very compact and easy to install, and I think this is a perfect match solution for filters coming from Circutor, AFQ, and eHome EV Charge, and similar solutions which are in the market. Okay, so very simple solution, but very good one. Next one, which is the WGB35TV. This is an RCD with an earth leakage transformer. This allows us to protect up to 125 amps, okay, 30 or 300 milliamps. The tripping curve can be instantaneous or selective. And again, it's a perfect match for AFQM and some solutions like that. RTU10B, the next one. This is the first solution with external current transformers that include in this presentation, okay? And this is very interesting because this product has a display, as you can see, and we can see in the first slide of the webinar, if you remember. And this allows us to protect more current than the previous one solutions. Up to 800 amps from the sensitivity, it's coming from 100 milliamps up to 3 amps, and the delays can be adjusted from 100 milliseconds to 10 seconds. Okay, so we know that this is a gap that we had in the catalog, because this solution do not include the 30 milliamps instantaneous trip, for which is a very common and very appreciated solution in the market, okay? But I will explain you in exclusive a launchment that we have in the following month that will cover that gap, okay? So finally, I will explain this RECB, okay, which is an RCCV with self-reclosing system. This product has launched to the market last month, okay? So at the beginning of March was launched into the market, and has the same features of the IDV4 which we have seen previously, but with self-reclosing system, okay? And before we leave, let me explain the next Type B launchments that we have prepared for the following months, because some of them are very interesting because are covering some of the gaps that we had in the catalog, okay? And we know that this should be a very interesting solution in order to cover the market, okay? So first of all, let me introduce the RGU100B and CBS400B, which can be used with the new earth leakage current transformers WGB, okay, which is a new range of products, all of them. And that solutions include a new R&D technology, which have been developed for the R&D department from Circutor, okay? And this new technology has developed the what we call the smart transformer technology. In that solution, electronics are incorporated in the transformers. The protection, the measurement, and the different calculations that the relay needs to be done has been done in the same transformer. Okay, this is what smart transformers technology means. Okay, and in order to do the measurement, it's absolutely necessary to put double core nanocrystalline inside these transformers. Okay, because one of them is absolutely dedicated to the alternating current. Okay, and the other one is dedicated to the DC current. And if you, as you probably know, DC current, it's quite difficult in order to measure. Okay, it's not measuring in the same way that the AC current, of course, because DC current do not generate any magnetic field in order to generate a signal in this transformer. But the system to measure this DC current is to apply some kind of energy to the core in order to know in which value the transformer has been blinded. Okay, and when in order that to see which energy we need to use to blind the transformer, we can calculate the DC current that we have in this transformer. So this is very special technology, not easy to explain. So please forgive me if I didn't explain very well, but for course, this is very, very new technology that our engineers have developed. Okay, so this product, the RGU-100B and the new transformers, WGB, which will be available at the end of April. Which physic features that we can see? Well, this solution will be up to 400 amps, okay? This will cover the gap that I was telling you before about the RGU-10B, which do not have the 30 milliamps instantaneous trip. So the sensitivities will come from 30 milliamps up to 3 amps, instantaneous selective trips and up to 10 seconds of delay. So we will cover a wide range of delays and different, a wide range as well of power supply, okay, in AC and DC as well. Different benefits, the display shows residual current in real time. When trips, the relay saves the tripping value and can be seen as AC and DC. So you will see both values, AC and DC. Okay, that gives you very important information in order to see where the problem is coming from. Okay, so very interesting, that special feature. High resolution display turns into red when tripped, so very easy to identify distance which relay have been tripped. We'll have even registered and very easy connection with a special, not with a special cable, but with a regular one with RJ45 connector, okay, which is an Ethernet conventional cable. And this allows us a very easy connection, because with the same cable, we are giving all the information to the relay, the measurement, the power supply, and the tripping value, okay? So very easy to connect in that sense. And pre-alarm and preventive maintenance. The solution includes communications as well. The same features applies to the CBS-400B. There's only one difference between the RGU-100B and the CBS-400B. CBS-400B have 4 independent channels. What does it mean? That means that we will able to connect up to 4 different transformers to protect 4 different lines to 4 different circuits, and each one will be or could be adjusted with different sensitivities and different delays. Okay, so in that sense, it's very, very interesting in order to save some space in the cabinet in case that you need more than more than one relay, type B, okay, because with this CBS 400B, you will not need four relays. You just need one relay and four transformers. Each one can be adjusted and with different values, as I said. Okay, I will not put the focus on the benefits because we are exactly the same as in the RGU-100B, which we have seen just 1 minute before. So that's it about the CBS 400B. So please keep the attention because we will give further information in the following weeks regarding this launchment. And finally, the next solution that I want to explain you is the IDA EV, which is the solution and very, very destined to cover the protection of EV charge points, okay? Covering that typical regulation, which is not only in Spain, but in other European countries, okay? And this product will be the perfect solution. This will not be a B-type solution. This will be A-type solution. So keep attention to the symbology next to the name. And that's it. This will be a very compact and easy to install solution. And I think that it will be very interesting in the market to cover that kind of application for EV charge. And finally, I want to put that slide, okay, just to summarize what we have seen, because we know that the EV solutions are very looked for the market. So everybody has very interesting in that solution. So we have seen some of them, and I want to put the focus on them before we leave. And well. That's it. We have other solutions under development with these products. And that's it about the presentation.